Learning with Leanne. Today's narration is by Leandra.
The Lion King, A Day Without Pumbaa. Said Timon the meerkat. Breakfast time. Come to daddy, you tasty little critters. Timon was showing Simba, the lion cub, how to catch some very sneaky bugs in the jungle. Too bad Pumbaa has to miss out on this feast, Simba said as he pounced on a juicy beetle. I haven't seen him since sunup, Timon replied. Oh, there's a good one. Watch me, Simba, and learn. Timon crouched behind a rotten log crawling with beetles. He was about to pounce when, ah! Pumbaa swooped out of the trees, swinging wildly in a vine. He plowed straight into Timon, flattening the meerkat like a pancake. Oops, sorry, Timon, Pumbaa said, picking himself up. Sorry, shouted Timon. Sorry, you say? That's the 19th, no, 20th time you've crashed into me this week. But it wasn't on purpose, Pumbaa told him. You never do anything on purpose, Timon replied. You're a natural disaster. Why, you couldn't catch a bug if it flew into your mouth. That's not true, Pumbaa protested, tears welling up in his eyes. Look, I'll prove it. The clumsy warthog lunged for a juicy grub, only to fall headfirst into a puddle. Mud splattered on Simba and Timon. That's it, cried Timon. I've had it. No more disasters. Pumbaa looked heartbroken. Do you think I'm a disaster too? He asked Simba. Well, Simba replied, you have to admit, sometimes you do things that are pretty disastrous. Pumbaa hung his head. You're right, he said. Nobody wants me around. It'd be better off for everyone if I just left. With that, Pumbaa slowly plodded off the jungle. Just then, the clouds thickened, and a bolt of lightning shot through the sky. Wait a second, said Simba. Timon, we can't let him go. But Timon wouldn't even turn to watch his friend leave. If that warthog thinks I'm going to beg him to stay, he's sorely mistaken, Timon said. Trust me, Simba, he'll be back by lunchtime. But as rain began to pour down, Simba wasn't so sure. The storm came and went, and then so did lunchtime. But still no Pumbaa. Simba began to worry. Simba looked off in the direction Pumbaa had gone. We shouldn't have been so hard on him, the lion cub said. I wonder if he's okay. He's fine, snapped Timon, who was still sore from getting squashed that morning. Besides, he's the one who walked out on us, remember? Poof, gone. History, as far as I'm concerned. Pumbaa, who's that? Never heard of him. Simba sighed. Oh, stop moping, Timon continued. And think about it. We can do anything we want now without worrying about getting knocked down, covered with mud, or run over. Let's enjoy it. As Timon marched off, Simba followed behind. First, Simba and Timon tried chasing vultures. Then they splashed into the river. They even tried playing a game of tag among the vines. But somehow, nothing they did seemed like very much fun. Something or someone was always missing. So what do you want to do now? Timon asked Simba. I don't know, Simba replied. What do you want to do?
I asked you first, said Timon. The sun began to dip below the horizon. Timon sighed. He was bored, and he admitted to himself it was also possible that he missed Pumbaa just a little.
By the time Simba and Timon finished dinner, they were both a little grumpy. They hadn't really enjoyed anything they had done that day. Soon, it would be bedtime, and their friends still hadn't returned. There's got to be something fun to do, said Simba. Well, Timon said gloomily, what do you want to do?
I don't know, said Simba. What do you want to do?
The pair went on and on and on, trying to think of fun things to do. They would have gone on even longer, but suddenly they heard a rustling sound coming from along the riverbank.
Timon, Simba, look what I found.
Wham! Pumbaa tumbled out of the jungle, knocking into Timon and Simba.
Pumbaa had brought bugs for his friends, but the critters went flying into the air.
"I'm back," Pumbaa said with a groan.
"So we see," Timon mumbled from beneath the warthog. Embarrassed, Pumbaa stood up and faced his friends.
"I came back to show you all the bugs I found," he said.
"But now look what I've done.
I'm the worst friend ever."
"Now wait a minute," cried Timon. "That's just not true. You're a wonderful friend, and we missed you," Simba said. "We've even missed your disasters."
Pumbaa stopped and turned towards his friends hopefully.
"It appears," Timon said with a small smile, "that we've grown accustomed to being stepped on, bruised, and squashed."
"Today was no fun without you," Simba exclaimed. "You're our very favorite disaster."
Pumbaa rushed toward them. As he did, he accidentally knocked over Timon and stepped on Simba's paw. But this time, his friends didn't really mind. As Simba curled up to sleep, he was already looking forward to the adventures that he would have the next day with both of his friends. The end.